morning, everybody. I am Ganesh Chandra Bhatto, faculty IHM, Kolkata. We are discussing about the working capital management, which is a very, very important chapter in financial management. We have already discussed in the last session the meaning of working capital, the components of working capital, the concepts of working capital, the types of working capital management, and need or importance of working capital management. In this session, we will discuss about the various factors that affect the working capital requirements of a business organization. Learning objectives of the session is that by the end of this session, the learner will be able to understand how the various factors influence the working capital needs of a business enterprise. There are a number of factors which determine the working capital needs of a business enterprise. Those factors are: 1. Nature of business, 2. Size of business, 3. Production policy, 4. Length of manufacturing process, 5. Seasonal variations, 6. Credit policy, 7. Working capital cycle, 8. Business cycle, 9. Growth and expansion of the business, 10. Earning capacity and dividend policy, 11. Changes in the general price level, 12. Operating efficiency, 13. Taxation policy, 14. Other factors. In this way, we shall discuss during this lesson all the 14 factors of working capital needs of a business enterprise. First one is nature of business. The working capital requirements of a business enterprise depends upon the nature of its business. Public utility concerns like electricity, water supply, natural gas, transport, etc. need very limited working capital to operate because they offer cash sales only and render services, not the products. No funds are tied up in the form of inventories and receivables. Hence, they require less amount of working capital. As compared to the public utility concerns, trading and manufacturing concerns require a larger amount of working capital to be invested in their businesses in the form of inventories, receivables, cash and bank balances. Number 2, size of business. Size of business means the scale of operations of a business enterprise. Whether it is operating with the large scale operations or it is operating with the small scale operations, that is the size of the business. The working capital needs of a business enterprise are largely affected by the size of its business. Normally, greater the size of a business, larger will be the requirements of working capital and vice versa. Means just the opposite. However, in some cases, even a smaller business concern may need more working capital due to its high overhead charges, inefficient use of available resources, etc. Number 3, production policy. The requirements of working capital in cases of wide fluctuations of demand due to seasonal variations depend upon the production policy of the firm. The production policy of the firm may either be to keep the production process steady by piling materials during the off season in order to meet high demand during the peak season, or to curtail the production process during the off season and would be increased during the peak season. Out of these two policies, the business concern may follow one policy. The requirement of working capital in the first case will be higher, whereas in the second case it will be lower. In this way, production policy also affects the working capital requirements of a business concern. Number four, length of manufacturing process. Manufacturing process is also known as the production cycle. That means the raw materials are converted into work in process, then work in process again processed into finished goods. The time taken from the raw material to the finished goods is called the length of production cycle, or it is called the length of the manufacturing process. In manufacturing concerns, the requirement of working capital increases in direct proportion to the length of manufacturing process. Longer the manufacturing process, larger will be the amount of working capital required, and vice versa. Means just the opposite. Therefore, it is advisable to choose the best alternative production process so that it can be completed within the shortest period of time and there will be less requirement of working capital. Number five, seasonal variations. In certain industries, raw materials are not available throughout the year. Therefore, they have to buy these raw materials in bulk quantities during the season in order to ensure the uninterrupted flow of production during the entire year. Therefore, a large amount of working capital is blocked in the form of inventories during such season. Number six, credit policy. The credit policy of a business concern depends upon the dealings with its debtors and creditors. This also influences considerably the requirement of working capital of the business concern. A business concern that purchases its requirements on credit basis and sells its products or services in cash will require lesser amount of working capital. On the other hand, a business concern that purchases its requirements in cash and allows credit to its customers will require larger amount of working capital, as a good amount of capital will be blocked in terms of receivables and stocks. 7. Working capital cycle or operating cycle. Working capital cycle refers to the length of time that a business concern takes to convert one part of its current assets to another. That is, time taken to convert cash into stock of goods, then into receivables, and finally again into cash. This cycle measures the speed with which a business enterprise turns its other current assets into cash. Thus, it reflects the ability and efficiency of the enterprise to manage its liquidity position. Shorter the working capital cycle, faster will be the conversion of other current assets into cash and vice versa. The speed with which the working capital completes one such cycle determines the requirement of working capital in a business enterprise. Longer the period of cycle, larger will be the requirement of working capital. Working capital cycle of trading and manufacturing concerns. In a trading concern, the working capital cycle happens through the first conversion of cash and bank balances into stock of finished goods, to conversion of such finished goods into receivables through sales, and finally, number three, conversion of these receivables into cash and bank balances. diagram of working capital cycle of a trading concern. This is the diagram of working capital cycle of a trading concern. Here the business concern has cash and bank balance. Out of this, stock of finished goods is created by purchasing. Then these finished goods are sold out, which create the receivables. And when money is collected from these receivables, again it comes to the original form of cash and bank balance. Now, working capital cycle of manufacturing concerns. In a manufacturing concern, the working capital cycle happens through first conversion of cash and bank balances into raw materials, two, conversion of these raw materials into finished goods, three, conversion of such finished goods into receivables through sales, and finally, four, conversion of these receivables into cash and bank balances. This is the diagram of working capital cycle of a manufacturing concern. In this diagram, the business concern has cash and bank balance. This is converted into raw materials. Then raw materials are converted into work in process, that means the semi-finished products. And from work in progress, it is converted into finished goods. And when finished goods are sold out, then receivables are created. And when money is collected from the receivables, again it comes to the form of cash and bank balance. 8. Business cycle. The requirement of working capital of a business enterprise is also affected by the business cycle. During the boom period, when the business is prosperous, there is a need of larger amount of working capital due to increase in demand, increase in sales, and increase in production. On the contrary, during depression, when the business contracts, firms require lesser amount of working capital as the demand falls, sales decline, production slows down, and difficulties are faced in collection from debtors. This is the diagram of business cycle. OX axis represents the period of time. OY axis represents the level of output. In this diagram, red color indicates the depression, fluorescent green indicates the recovery, sea green indicates the expansion, and deep green indicates the boom. Then after boom, the stabilization, it is indicated in yellow color. Then the recession stage, it is indicated with light red, and again depression with deep red. So these are the various stages of business cycle. When the business is in depression, there is lower demand in the market, lower sales, lower production. And when it improves, the stage is called recovery. And after recovery, it comes to the expansion stage. And after expansion, it comes to the peak period of the business, that is boom. And after covering the boom period, it is the stabilization period. And then it comes to the recession. And finally, it comes to the depression. In this way, it is clearly indicated in this diagram, the business cycle. 9. Growth and expansion of the business. The requirement of working capital in a business enterprise increases with the rate of growth and expansion of its business activities. Fast growing concerns will require larger amount of working capital as compared to the slow growing concerns. That means when the business concern grows, it will require larger amount of capital, and when the business contracts, then it will require lesser amount of working capital. 10. Earning capacity and dividend policy. The earning capacity and dividend policy of a business firm also influence its working capital requirements. Firms having higher earning capacity may generate cash profits from operations and contribute much to their working capital. So, they require less amount of working capital as compared to the firms having lower earning capacity. A firm that maintains a steady high rate of cash dividend needs more working capital than the firm that pays cash dividend at a lower rate. In this way, the rate of dividend also decides the amount of capital required in a business. Changes in the general price level of the country also affect the working capital requirements. At the times of rising prices, firms will require larger amount of working capital to maintain the same current assets and vice versa. That means the opposite. 12. Operating efficiency. 12. Operating efficiency. Operating efficiency of a business results in optimum utilization of resources at minimum cost. A business firm having high operating efficiency is able to control its operating cost to a large extent, by which it will be able to improve its net earnings or net profits. So, it will require lesser amount of working capital as compared to the business firm having low operating efficiency. 13. Taxation policy. Taxation policy also affects the working capital requirements of a business concern. Regressive taxation policy of the government imposes heavy tax burdens on the business enterprises, so they are left with very little profit for distribution as dividend and retention purposes. The business enterprises have to borrow additional funds to meet their increased working capital needs in such a case. The pressure on working capital is minimized, particularly when the liberal taxation policy is followed. Other factors. Certain other factors such as managerial ability, import policy, banking facilities, depreciation policy, technological developments, transport and communication system, availability of skilled labor, etc. also influence the working capital requirements of a business organization. Now the key points. Working capital need of a business enterprise is affected by a number of factors such as nature of business, size of business, production policy, length of manufacturing process, seasonal variations, credit policy, working capital cycle, business cycle, growth and expansion of the business, earning capacity and dividend policy, changes in the price level, operating efficiency, taxation policy, etc. Now, you will have to do some exercises on this topic. Question number 1. Discuss the various factors that influence the working capital requirements of a business enterprise. In this question, you will have to write all the 14 factors that influence the working capital requirements of a business enterprise. Question number 2. Explain the working capital cycle of both the trading and manufacturing concerns with the suitable diagrams. We have already discussed there are two types of diagrams. One is for the trading concerns and the other one is for the manufacturing concerns separately. That we will have to follow it or answer it. There are certain reference books that I want to suggest you. Here there are 5 reference books I have suggested. Along with this session you can refer to these books. Hope you have enjoyed this session. We will meet in the next session with a new topic. Thank you.